allows these things to happen. UCT can, however, choose to influence the contractors that we pay. UCT dictates, as a condition of these contracts with these companies, the minimum amount that they must pay their employees. No public institution should pay wages which are as low as our workers receive. The current measure that is used to determine what the wages is, should be is called the supplemented living wage, an outdated apartheid-era way to justify low wages. Another way we avoid blame is that saying that these aren't poor services. So we're acting in some perfectly rational, non-racist way of outsourcing the particular jobs that we outsource. Make no mistake, that's not the logic that determines whether a job is or is not outsourced. For example, our shuttles are run by a mix of people employed directly by UCT and by Savanya, the outsourcing company. The timetables are drawn up by well-paid UCT employees, while the buses are driven by badly paid Savanya. Last year, we paid Savanya 27 million rand to provide shuttles and drivers according to our specifications. The same year, UCT's own finance department worked out that to buy all of the shuttles and employ all of the drivers as better paid UCT employees with retirement funds and medical aid would only cost 28 million rand. 1 million rand more than we pay to buy. We can afford to pay those people. We can afford to insource. We just don't want to. We don't want to insource. We here means an out-of-touch, racist, old management with the permission of an academic student body. This university should be run by its students. It is run by its students. Only we've let some old white men do a bunch of racial evil. Demonstrated the fact that it's really us who run this university by removing the statue of Rome. Now it's time to get rid of outsourcing. We cannot continue to tolerate the exploitation, victimization, and intimidation of outsourced workers. We cannot continue to not take responsibility when we are responsible. We demand that outsourcing becomes a principal commitment of a decolonized African public university.
I think it's very important because I think 2 weeks ago I tweeted and we found out a week later that one of the cleaners who used to work at Leslie Social passed away. One of the ladies who used to work here for many years passed away and UCT didn't bother to send an email to notify students that a community member of UCT has passed away. But all the time when it's a professor, when it's somebody else, we get those emails. So out of respect, I'd like us to just take just 1 minute of silence to say to that woman, thank you for working in this institution and helping us, because they're doing this for us, is to make our lives complete. So can we please just take that 1 minute? Thank you.
Atari Honda Mama.